Let's open John 5.
John chapter 5.
37.
Verse 37, chapter 5.
And the Father who sent me has himself testified about me. You have never heard his voice, nor seen his form. You do not have his word, scripture, abiding in you, actually living in your hearts and minds, because you don't believe in him who has sent. You search and keep on searching and examine the scriptures, because you think that in them you have eternal life, and yet it is those very scriptures that testify about me. And still you are unwilling to come to me so that you may have life. Verse 41, I do not receive glory and approval from men, but I know you and recognize that you do not have the love of God in yourselves. I have come in my Father's name with his power, and you do not receive me, because your minds are closed. But if another comes in his own name, and with no authority or power except his own, you will receive and give your approval to an impostor. How can you believe in me when you receive, when you seek and receive glory and approval from one another, and yet you do not seek the glory and approval which comes from one and only God? Do not think that I'm the one who will accuse you before the Father. There already is one who accuses you, Moses, the very one in whom you have placed your hope for salvation. For if you believe and relied on the scripture written by, for he wrote about me personally, but if you do not believe his writings, how will you believe my ways? I was reading the scriptures. I found the heart of Jesus. Jesus faced a lot by his time of the ministry. Here he was addressing the leaders of the church. That the leaders of the church were searching scriptures and keep on searching. But they could not come to a revelation of knowing God. Have you ever found that you are reading scripture but you don't have a revelation of your Father God? These are the people who were preaching the gospel. What's more, the followers? Because Jesus said, these people, they keep on searching scriptures, but the scriptures does not make them to see God as he is. If they can see God as he is, they will love him. And they will understand that the love of God is manifested through Christ in them. You know, when I read this, I remember when Paul told Timothy that people in the last day, they will have a form of goldenness. There will be actions of showing they know God. But whereas they have denied him. Not long I found that whatever we are doing now is no longer for God. We are doing it for our names. We need to be recognized. We need to give each other's glory. Here, you see, he said, I'm not saying this to accuse you.
So ore a bolela mo a ke bolele sengoto le pharamelato.
You were supposed to be knowing the revelation of me from the scriptures.
Ne le tamelo ba letse ba kutulo ya ka otwa morao mangwalo.
But you keep on searching scriptures that don't bring you to the love of God.
Mara le tshela pele nya ka mangwala a silitse nkara le rato la rata modimo.
I found that we are lacking the love of God in us.
Ke lebeletse ka tlo re shota ka le rato la modimo go rena.
Because the love of God shapes our character.
Ka re le rato la modimo la lebetla megwa ya rena.
There are things that we cannot do when we love God.
Bona le dilo tse re ka se re di dirile fa re rata modimo.
But there are things.
Bona le dilo.
That we will never do.
Tse o ka se di dirile.
The reason is because we love God.
Le ba ka ile re gore wena o rata modimo.
If you love God already, you are destined on the righteousness of God.
A o rata modimo se tshe be tshe tseleng ya go rata modimo ya botho ba modimo.
If you love God, there are things that when they come your way, you say no.
A o rata modimo na le dilo tshe di tang tseleng ya wa tsho tsho nang ka se di fitelele ka
sekolo. Because searching of the scriptures.
Ka bana go nyaka le
tshe. Take you to the revelation of Christ.
O nyaka mangwalo di usa kotolong ya Christ.
And the revelation of Christ shows the love of God.
And a kotolo ya Christ e bo ntsha le rato la modimo le re le filweng lona.
The searching of scriptures.
Jana o nyaka mangwalo.
Must tell you that God has loved you through Christ.
A tsonjo botsa wena re modimo ba o ratile ka Kriste.
And now if Christ has come because of the love of God.
Jana ha Kriste atile ka lebaka la le rato la modimo go rena.
Your character is bound to change.
Me hwaye ya rena ita mailo no fetuwa.
You cannot live like you don't know God.
Boka sephile o ka re modimo o motsebe.
If we read 1 Corinthians 8 verse 3.
Are ka ya re ba la ba Korinta ba pele.
It says, but if anyone love God, if you love God, you are known by God. In other words, our love for God establish our relationship with him. If really you know God, you are known by him. Our relationship began when we loved
him.
In the last days, the thing that will be questioned is how far are you with the relationship with him? Your activities you do shows the fruits of your relationship with him. Your, how you relate with him is from the love of God in you. How do we know that you love God? If we read 1 John chapter 4, we read verse 20. Just read, the Bible says, you cannot say you love God when you hate your brother. In the Amplified Bible it says, when you love God, you cannot work against your brother. Can you read verse 20?
If someone says, I love God, and hates his brother, he is a liar. For he who does not love his brother whom he has seen, how can he love God whom he has not seen?
The maturity of your Christian life is determined by how you act towards your brother.
O hola pulushong ya hao o ya le ka hore wena le rato la hao mo botle fitakai.
Therefore, the way, when your brother challenges you,
jana ha buti
wa hao ai ta o wena o challenge maturity in the love of God.
O araba ga ga go bontsha hore le rato la mo re rena o godile o fitakai go lona.
Therefore, it means you will never quench the challenges.
Ora uri di challenge tse o ka setsoe o di fukuditse ba o di tima.
If you quench the challenges, it means there is no more temptations.
A o tima di challenge ora uri pholoso a iyo a wa pholoso.
If there is no more temptations, you are no longer a Christian.
A me le kwa ise ora ora ra pholoswa.
So all the challenges you are facing towards your brother.
Fela tsona tse re kopana le tsona di lebane le boti. Ditiswa ka botiao.
They are there to challenge the love of God.
Di o nao challenge le rato le leng go wena la modimo.
So for you to stand tall.
Jana o ema o re wena o tla o eme botsu tshele pele ga botse.
In the righteousness of God.
Mo tukong ya modimo.
Determine your maturity in the things of God.
O bontsha re wena o go dilo fita kae ha re tatabeng tsa modimo.
The love of God in you will always be challenged.
Le rato la modimo e halele go wena le tatula le challenge iwe.
When you are praying.
A o rapela.
You'll be challenged to stop praying.
O ta challenge o rutuele thapelo.
Because if you love God, you will say, I will not look at the challenge. If you worship, you'll be challenged to stop worshiping. Whatever you do, you will be challenged. I don't know if you're hearing me. The moment you see challenges coming to you, maintain the love of God in you. Maintain it. Make sure that you don't lose the love of God. I love when the Bible says Jesus recognized.
As
when I look at you, I recognize. In other words,
he
could see them in spirit. Listen, if we cannot see people in spirit, we are in danger. Because the love of God will always fluctuate. I don't know if you're hearing me. How far is the love of God in you? Is it not fluctuating? Because when money is not there, it fluctuates. Sickness, when it comes, it fluctuates. So you need to maintain it. Because it's the love of God in you that takes you to where God wants you to go. It's not people. Tell about, it is the love of God in you that takes you to where God is. It's not people. I mean, let's take away our eyes from people. We put our lives in the scripture that reveals Christ so that we understand the full love of God. So how do we know? We know that we cannot work against each other. Number two, in 1 John 5:2, by obeying the commandments, when he instructs us, we obey. So therefore, the commandments, you obey them because you love God. Even when you have got interest. Sometimes, you know, devil will show you your interest. Some things that will come up to make you to stop doing what God wants you to
do.
Not only that, in commands, temptations. So your obedience is the reflections of the love of God in you. Can you tell about obedience? Is the reflections of the love of God in you. I want to tell you something. When God tested Abraham, when he tested Abraham, he said, Abraham, go to Mountain Moriah. But he chose the best there. He said, take Isaac, not Ishmael. If God said to Abraham, Ishmael, you know, Abraham will just say, Abraham, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You know, he will just say,
Ishmael,
let's go. When in the road, this, when he
asks,
when he say, no, who's... What are we going to offer? Abraham will not even ask.
Answer.
You know, he answered Isaac. He said,
Isaac,
the law will provide. But if it was
Ishmael,
when he said, what are we going to offer? He said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Because he knows he doesn't lose anything. We love to give thanks to God because we, you know, we are not affected. That's why maybe the Bible says we must sow in tears.
That's why Bible
because obedience required our heart. Out.
It challenges our hearts.
I don't know if you are hearing me. Tell somebody, say, hey, obedience, it challenges you and ask you questions before you act. You will feel pain before you act. Your maturity in obedience
is
checked in the pain you feel before you act. Sometimes God will allow you to do something that causes you pain. And you realize, I cannot do it. I felt pain. If I carry on doing it, I felt pain. I won't do it. You stop. And when you stop, you are stopping your promotion. I don't know if you are hearing me.